Oh, yeah, baby. Feels good. Feels good. What's up, guys? Sean and TQ here with Spencer's Lawn Care.
What's up, everyone?
TQ is currently filming for me, but I'm going to pull the truck and trailer down to the end of the driveway here. We're going to get one of these mowers off here, and we're going to get this bad boy running, aren't we, TQ?
We sure are.
I don't care if it's the last thing we do. I'll tell you what, if I don't get it to work, though, it's going in a fire pit in this video. Let's go. I have never worked on small engines before, ever. I'm telling you right now. But I did do some research last night, and I watched probably 5 videos. So I kind of have a general idea of what goes into these carburetors and how to kind of fix them a little bit, or at least clean them, and kind of knock one bad thing off of the list. If it doesn't work, we move on to the next thing. But everything I'm reading, these mowers, these engines, the 500 E-Series, have carburetor problems. We're going to figure it out. Never done it before, but I got TQ. And with TQ, we're going to power on through. Let's go. Real quick, a lot of you commented, Sean, you need to get a drop hitch. You need to get a drop hitch. We ordered a drop hitch, guys. It is currently on the way, so don't worry about the drop hitch anymore. Let's go. Guys, we're gonna just start with this one right off the rip.
If you enjoy these types of videos, consider subscribing to the channel, hitting the like button, and turning on your notification bell so that every time we upload a video, you'll get notified.
I'm gonna try to pinch off this line so I can get the gas tank off. And it just so happens to be the one size I don't have. Went ahead and got the carb off of it. I think they call this the bowl. Oops, I'm dripping. The tank itself had no dirt in it. The line wasn't dirty at all, but you can see this. See this discoloration in here? It's telling me this bowl's probably pretty filthy. So we're gonna go ahead. The gasket seems okay. Both these ones that are in here seem okay. The lock-in one and the little rubber one on the inside look okay. Why can't people make one size? We went ahead and made a few changes. I went and washed the gas off my hands, threw on some gloves. I don't know why I didn't do it in the first place. I mean, TQ is normally on me about that kind of stuff. I'm kind of just like, yeah, get grease and all that stuff all over my hands, whatever.
I actually forgot about I had those gloves.
But I'm gonna go ahead, pry it open here. Nasty junk, I know that. I don't know, guys, you tell me, does that look like it's clogged or is that how it's supposed to be? I'm going to get the air hose. I'm going to blow these out. I want to see if that stuff comes out because that may be our problem. Okay, so I just blew the carburetor out. That dark spot is definitely supposed to be there, but if you can see now, we have a real teeny pinhole. Super small. That could be what was clogging this up, not allowing the fuel to get into the carburetor. We're gonna go ahead and do a real good cleaning on it now. All right, fellas, so we got everything as clean as I can possibly get it. Took it all apart, got it with carb cleaner, blew everything out that I can see. Now we just gotta figure out how to put it back together. Just putting these couple screws back in. Man, I really wish I had that set. That other piece for that DeWalt drill, you know. Good enough there. Good enough there. Ugh. So then you got to put the cable back in there. Goes in simple enough. Or no, hold on.
That goes over top.
Over top?
Yeah. There you go.
Glad you remember. I want to make sure I got a good seal there, so. Looks good, huh? I'm trying to remember myself now, fellas. We got to put the fuel line back on with the gas tank. Probably be easier to put this on now, huh?
Yeah.
Tell you what, this is not the job to do on the ground, fellas. Definitely put it up higher. When I do the rest of these, if this works, definitely be putting them up higher. All right, so basically we just put that clamp back on the hose there. Go ahead and reseat the fuel tank. Honestly, it's pretty simple, fellas. It's just learning. I don't know these, but this is a great thing to learn. Honestly, it is. Tell you what, if you can get this down, it'd be a good little hobby, you know? Maybe a Spencer Lawn Care small engine shop in the near future.
Spencer small engine repair.
I mean, honestly, if I had the right tools and I wasn't bending over, this would actually be somewhat enjoyable.
Oh, shoot. We have life.
Spencer's Lawn Care, small engine repair. Open for business, boys. Go ahead, swing them by. We'll hook you up.
All right, babe. You just got a whole another trailer full.
Well, I'm only doing one today because I definitely have to get a better platform set up. Obviously, put this up top.
Yeah.
Get it up higher. Get me a bench I can sit my butt on, be a little bit lazy.
We got some picnic tables out back we could use for now.
No. What? But guys, you have no idea. That's an exhilarating feeling. It feels good, don't it, Miley?
Yeah.
Go ahead, throw me the football. Oh. Yeah, baby. Feels good. Feels good. It feels good. Nothing like fixing your own crap, right?
All right, put some gas in it and let it run.
All right.
Where's the gas?
That feels good.
Miley, can you grab the gas can and bring it out here, please?
Yeah, the 5-gallon for Daddy, please.
Where is it?
It's right. The big red one.
And does that feel good? Thank you, baby.
As our next employee for the summer.
Grab me those silver or gray earmuffs on top, too. On top of the toolbox. Now I want to kind of keep it, because I fixed it.
Well, I feel like we should keep one of those.
I was thinking about keeping one.
Those look like good mowers.
I still have the Toro also, down at the storage, but that one's kind of on its last leg. Yes, please.
Why is that covering his ears?
It's going to be loud.
You're far enough away, Miley. You're good.
Yeah, stay up there. I guess we gotta prime it, huh?
Not too much, because that sucker's clean.
Still gotta get fuel into that line. Alright guys, that is what it's all about. Me and TQ came out here, got it started just a little bit ago. Miley just got home from school. Did you learn anything from that, just seeing the last little half an hour of what we did?
Work hard.
Work hard?
Yeah.
Yep, and you can fix things if you apply yourself to them, right?
Keep trying, right?
Yep, keep trying. That's what I call success. Now I know we can fix the rest of them more than likely. Now I know we're going to be able to resell them for profit. And that's what it's all about, taking a chance in life, guys. I bought that $300 storage unit with no guarantee that I was going to make my money back or these things were going to run. Now I know, hey, I can apply myself, put a little work into them, fix them, get them going.
Now you know what you're doing and it won't take as long.
Oh, for sure. I think now I could probably do one in probably 15 minutes tops, just going through them, cleaning them. Oh, man, it just feels good. And I learned something new, guys. I've never taken a push mower apart before in my entire life, I swear. Who are you raising your hand for? Oh, I thought you had something else you want to say. So, as always, guys,
keep mowing.
Keep growing.
Keep making money, boys.
We'll talk to you later.
Take you out.
Peace, guys.